Hello everyone and welcome again to my channel. Today we will talk about the last lesson in health, which is about prevention and control of substance use and abuse. For our learning competencies, at the end of the lesson you'll be able to discuss strategies in the prevention and control of substance use and abuse, apply decision making and resistance skills to prevent substance use and abuse, and suggest healthy alternatives to substance use and abuse. So what are the different strategies in the prevention and control of substance use and abuse? Addiction treatment must help the person to do the following. First is to stop using the substance or drug. So say no to drug and get yourself out of the situation quickly. Second is to stay drug-free. So you may get into sports or other interests or enroll in art, dance, or voice lesson. Third is to be productive in the family, school, and community. So you may participate in school clubs or organizations and join cause-oriented projects such as tree planting, feeding, and coastal cleanup. Drug treatment and rehabilitation. Drug-dependent treatment and rehabilitation can be classified into the following. First is voluntary, which means that a drug dependent or patient decides on his or her own to be examined and is willingly admitted in the rehabilitation center. The second is voluntary through representations. So the drug dependent or patient is willingly admitted to a rehabilitation center for treatment but wants to be accompanied by a trusted adult member of the family, relative, or legal guardian. And lastly, compulsory confinement. The drug dependent or patient is in a life-threatening situation or is a threat to his or her family, thus needs to be confined. So what is the Department of Health's drug treatment and rehabilitation and their modalities? First is intake and admission. So this is the process of determining whether a particular rehabilitation center is good or fit for the patient. Then followed by diagnostic evaluation, treatment, and rehabilitation proper, where they undergo some diagnostic tests or screening to best determine how the program can most optimally tailor its treatment. The third is detoxification. So this is the process by which the body clears itself from drugs and followed by medical and psychiatric treatment, where a formal assessment and referral to drug addiction treatment. And lastly, they have psychological and social services. This is the most common form of treatment wherein there is a behavioral therapy that involves some combination of individual groups and family therapy. Other treatment and rehabilitation ways of Department of Health are education and vocational services, wherein an opportunity shall be made available to patients for the purpose of improving their skills, interests, and capabilities. Spiritual development services, where they will help them feel more supported as they seek healing from addiction. Sports and recreation, where it provides facilities for sports and recreation to offer patients the opportunity to engage in constructive activities and to establish peer relationship. Aftercare and follow-up services. After patients have completed their rehabilitation program, they are not finished with recovery. So it is a journey that requires a lifelong support. So kaya kinakailangan na mga aftercare or follow-up services. And they also have job placement services. So it provides assistance to drug dependent in obtaining work opportunities through open self and sheltered employment. So makikita natin na meron talagang plano ang Department of Health para matulungan yung mga tao na nagkaroon ng addiction sa drugs. So hindi lang siya basta dinadala sa mga rehabilitation centers, kundi meron din silang mga programa na kung saan sila nag-undergo para mapabuti yung kanilang kalagayan o ma-heal sila doon sa addiction na kanilang kinasagnakan. So what are the different decision making and resistance skills that we should have in order to resist yung addiction ng drugs? So here are some statements for each resistance skills. So first is identifying the right decision. So you may say, "No thanks, my parent will ground me for life." Or say, "Sorry, no, there are more interesting and less disruptive activities to choose from, which are legal." So, in case na halimbawa na ikaw ay may mag-aya sa'yo na mag-take ng drugs, ito yung mga pwede mong isagot sa kanila. So, next is yung valuing your own opinion. You may say, sorry but I cannot join. I have scheduled choir practice in a few minutes and I need to go now. So, or you may say, honestly, I do not feel like joining now but I will be in a sports gym playing basketball with my team. Kasi yun, so pwede mo explain sa kanila na meron kang iba mga activities, mas mahalam nga muna ginagawa. And third is stating your views assertively. So ito yung talagang ipapaliwanag mo o sasabihin mo kung ano yung paniniwala mo nang mas may pagpupursige o na mas sigurado ka. Yan. So, no, I would rather engage in a Paris civic activities. Want to join me? Yan. Or you may say, thanks, but I was planning to join my cousin's Katya book sale in the mall. I would love for you to come with me. My brothers can drop us off. So, maaari mo siyang ayain sa mas mabuti kaysa sa ikaw yung mag-join sa kanya sa masama, di ba? And lastly is to clarify and question. So, you may ask that person, why would you try that chunk? Or, have you not heard of the teen in the news who died from drug abuse? Or, go ahead if you want to ruin your life. Or, do you like that? I do not. Yan. So, maaari mo siyang sabihin sa kanya ng malinaw na masama yung kanyang ginagawa. So, healthy alternatives to substance or drug use and abuse. So, this is the last topic that we'll talk about. And here are the list of healthy alternatives to substance or drug use and abuse. First is healthy human interaction and relationship. So, sobrang mahalaga na meron kang mabubuting mga kaibigan at mga pamilya, mga klase, mga teachers, mga tao na maaaring makatulong sa iyo na na mapabuti ka sa halip na makasama sa iyo yung kanilang pakikisama sa iyo. So, kailangan hanapin din natin yung mga tao na makakapagdala sa atin sa mabuti at hindi sa masama. So, second is yung meaningful activities. We can engage in different meaningful activities like yun nga, yung binanggit natin. You can engage in sports, in yung mga civic activities, in musical activities, in art activities, diba? Yung mga iba mga bagay na mas makabuluhan, na mas marami tayong natututunan at may itutulong sa ating kapwa. So, yun nga sinasabi natin na meaningful activities. Then, talk therapy or psychotherapy. Kadalasan naman sa mga tao na nagiging involved sa drugs is talagang meron silang mga problema pinagdadaanan. Diba? Yun yung diniscuss natin ng nakaraan. Talagang majority sa kanila, may pinagdadaanan sila, kaya sila nagtitake ng drugs. So kung kayo man ay may pinagdadaanan at kayo ay malaki yung mga problema ninyo or nakakaranas kayo ng mga emotional disturbances, then it would be better to talk to a therapy, to talk to a therapist or undergo psychotherapy rather than go to drugs. Kasi yun ang mga tao na maaari makatulong sa'yo sa halip na sa makakasira ng buhay mo yung paggamit ng mga illegal drugs. And then fourth is exercise. Yun, di ba dati pinag-usapin natin that physical activity could really manage yung mga mental and emotional problems ng isang tao. So, kapag halimbawa tayo ay nalulungkot o meron tayong mga problema, it is better na mag-exercise tayo. Hindi lang tayo mawawala, hindi lang mawawala yung lungkot natin, kundi magiging healthy pa tayo. And number five is diet. And yun na nga yun. So, pagkain ng tama at mga healthy. And lastly is to have balance in life. Kaya naman talaga nagkakaroon ng problema sa buhay kasi hindi natin nagagumbalansihin ang mga bagay-bagay sa buhay natin, di ba? May mga ibang bagay tayo na sobra natin nabibigyan ng priority na nanineglect naman natin yung ibang mga importanteng bagay like our relationship to our parents, our relationship to God, di ba? Yung minsan masyado tayo nagpo-focus sa mga problema o sa pag-aaral o dun sa mga trabaho, di ba? Na nakakalimutan natin yung mga bagay na mas mahalaga para sa buhay natin. So, kinakailangan na tutunan natin na balansehin ang ating buhay. So, hindi lang tayo nakafocus sa isang area lang, kundi bigyan din natin ng pansin yung ibang mga bagay na nane-neglect natin para magkaroon ng mas malusog na pangangatawan, mas matalas sa pag-iisip, at mas masayang buhay. So, that ends my discussion and I hope that you learned something from me. Our performance task is already posted in our Google Classroom. And I would also appreciate if you would like and subscribe to my channel because that will help me a lot. So stay safe, everyone. Have a happy new year and God bless us all.